What is up, guys? It's your boy Lisa Mutupi, and I'm glad that you made it back on my YouTube channel. Now, in today's video, we're actually going to be speaking about a question that I asked on Instagram. I actually asked the members to maybe ask me questions that they would like me to speak about, and I got a lot of messages of members giving me text out there, giving me things like to just dive in a bit deep onto. But the one that stood out for me was actually Claudius asking me, I would prefer you give us a real biography of how much you started trading worth. So that's something that actually stood out, and it's a story that I did mention before, but I never jumped into details with. So I want to share that in today's video. So please do make sure to hit the like button if you're getting value, if you're liking the content that I speak about, the words that I say. At the same time, make sure to subscribe if this video is helping you in any manner out there. So let us jump on to today's video. But hey, if you've been watching my videos for a while now, you'd know the story whereby I spoke about me starting an account with my very first trading account was literally $22. So yeah, like I've got $22 here in my hands, as you can see, 200 rands, 50 rands, 20 rands and 10 rands. This is like literally 300 rands here. And I started trading with only 300 rands because that's, by the time, that's the only amount that I had. And at the same time, like I couldn't get more money, or I didn't even know much about forex trading and stuff. So I can't just jump into the market without knowing, and then I invest a lot of money into it. So the only amount that I had, because I was still in college, I was doing college time, so I actually managed to sell a few things while I was still in college, because I've always had the entrepreneurial mindset or the spirit of me selling things and then making profit for that. So I was actually able to sell a few things, and then the quickest profit that I made was like 300 rands. So from there after making the 300 rands, I was like, you know what, I've been reading a lot of things about forex, I've been watching a lot of YouTube videos, how about I just jump onto it, you know, how about I just invest this money that I made, and then I see how much it will take, how much it will actually make me in profit. So I started doing that. Obviously, $22, within a day I made like I made $10, because my balance was on $33, and I was excited. But by the time I was trading forex, but I wasn't actually trading like forex as like currencies, you know, I didn't know much about it. So I jumped into IQ options. And when I jumped into IQ options, there were like Apple, there were Facebook, there were all these things. So I was just like literally buying and selling. I didn't know what was happening, but I was trying to just make a quick buck, you know, make profit. That's the only thing that we wanted to do in the market. And then obviously after making the $10, then following day, I blew it all off. And I actually came again with a friend that was literally trading, and like he kept on telling me about it, but I didn't take it to heed. So this one day he actually called me over for lunch, and then he mentioned to me about MetaTrader 4 platform. I was like, how does it operate? What is MetaTrader platform and all these things? So he showed me, sat down with me, he was patient with me, actually showed me going through MetaTrader, showed me whereby he funded his account with a few dollars, and then he was explaining to me that the way that you trade IQ options, thing is like when you just buy now, within 1 minute, it has to be above that where you bought to make profit and all these things. So I was like, yeah. And he was telling me the difference with MetaTrader, when you buy and then the more you hold, the money goes into your direction, the more money you make. And I was like, wow, that's amazing. So I can just have a small amount, then I just buy and then I hold for too long. He's like, yeah, that's how it works. So I got excited, I got fascinated. Now I don't have money because I blew all the money that I had. But I went back again and I was selling, but this time, because I was too much focused on forex trading, obviously I didn't make much, and I actually had to literally go out and ask my mom, because one thing that I noticed is that from my side, like, you know, to be honest, like I actually lost a lot of money from my side into the markets, because like even though when I kept on hustling, making a few profits, I'd try to just fund the forex market, even though it was like 200 rands next and then 500 rands and all these small amounts of money. But I was a bit impatient, and I started seeing or listening or hearing that to make a lot of money you actually need a large amount of capital. So to me, a large amount of capital was like literally $200. There was large amounts of capital to me. I was like, if I have $200, I'm gone. Like nobody will ever get to see me. But by that time, you know, I've been so much invested into forex trading, and I've been like so much like learning and being concentrated on like understanding this whole concept of the markets. So at school, back in college, I started like slacking a bit. And then at the same time, like, you know, whatever hustle that I was pushing when I was still in college, I slacked a bit, because, you know, I stopped going there because I was reading books, I'm trading books, I was watching a few videos, so I couldn't focus more about all these things. So I just started not paying attention into college. Then I went full on forex trading. But by that time, remember, my account was still low. I had like, I think by that time I didn't even have an account. So I had to sit down with my mom, you know, I sat down with her, I was like, no, take a look at this. I had to convince her in a way whereby like she also believed that okay, this guy can make it out, because, you know, One thing that I like is that before trading Forex, I was a lot of involved into a lot of things, you know. I was a few involved into maybe street activities, you know. I was like not disciplined. I was like, you know, this kid that's always out there. But when I started trading Forex, you know, I started being a bit more disciplined, you know. I started just being indoors a lot, you know, reading books, and I started just understanding like my mindset. When a person sits down with me and speak, you know, I was growing a bit, you know, because I was like doing a lot of things that were actually helping me stay focused, stay dedicated, and I knew what I wanted, you know. Because before that, you know, when a person spoke with me, you'd know that this guy doesn't have any direction. I'd say all types of things. I'll just be my mindset was like in a totally different position. So now when she spoke with me, she could see that, okay, no, this guy, when I sit down with them, speaking with them, it actually makes sense. So I sat down with them. Then I told them, this was actually happening. I'm trading Forex, but this thing is killing me. I need capital. I'm making profits. And then I showed her like a few profits and losses that I made. You know, I was telling her that I'm not consistent yet. I'm still learning, but please, like, can you please borrow me? Even if it's like $200, I think 2.5 thousand rands in our currency, $200. And then I promise I'm going to make profits, and then I'm going to bring it back to you, and we're going to be rich, and I'll be buying you all types of things. I was telling her all that, you know, and she didn't want to believe it. So I had to just go on social media, show her other youngsters that were making it, like, you know, trading for, I don't know how they got to make it, but I was just showing her, these kids are kids my age, and they're making this much money, they're just making money, please allow me to also be in such positions. As you can see, I'm not interested in school. But obviously she didn't take the school one. She was like, okay, you know what, I don't have money, you know, we don't have money back home, but I do have a credit card, and then I'll just withdraw I'll just withdraw money from the credit card, and then know that like I'll be in the negatives, so you better bring it back. I was like, I promise I'm gonna bring it back. Then she gave me the 2.4. I was excited, you know. At that time, I was like, wow, I'm gonna be rich, you know. I'm gonna take this account to $1,000. From there, it's gonna be like $10,000, and we're gonna be out of poverty. All these things, I started thinking all that way. So obviously, like, it didn't happen that way. I made a few profits at the same time. Then I made a few losses. So I was now in the negatives. Instead of being now on $200, like floating maybe $115. So I'm thinking to myself, how am I gonna pay back my mom? She's gonna think that like this thing doesn't work. I'm gonna be in like a lot of situations whereby I won't be able to just control them, you know, and I'll be forced to go back to school whereby I don't even like going back there, and all these things. So I was like, I have to make it work. That's when I came together with two guys. I remember I spoke about them, whereby I was like, we took an account from £181 all over to £3,200 in just a week. I came together with them, and then we're like, okay guys, no, let us try to grow our accounts, but because we don't have a lot of money and we need a bigger amount of capital, let us all put into one account and then trade it together. That way we'll be able to take those profits and then share them. We're like, amazing. So we all came. We mixed up our profits, and then we had a GBP account. Yeah, it was a pound account, and the total was like 181, because you know we all didn't have that much money, so we just literally started off with 181 as a team together. And then from there, like in just 4 days, we're able to take it over to I think it was like £3,200. And then on that same day, on Friday, we actually lost £2,000, so we're left with like £1,000 and a few. And then from there, we're like, okay, no, let's take our profits, you know, divide it into three, and then we'd be able to take. Then I think I took home somewhere around $400, somewhere, I think it was like that, the profits that we all shared. And then with that $400, I was like, okay, no, what, should I give back my mom the 200 and then play around with the 200? Then I started thinking, I was like, no, you know what, like, let me try to grow this account. Then when I grow it, I'll be able to just make more and then give her back without even worrying about it. And I won't give her back the amount that she gave me, but give her more than that. So I started focusing on that. I took, I think it was like a few dollars from that 400 rands, and then I invested into an online course. And after that, I went, and then I started focusing more on the markets, you know. And also the lessons that are like all the losses that I experienced, all the accounts that I blew, they actually taught me something. They taught me that even if like I do take losses, in the long run I can be profitable, you know, because I was able to see myself making a few profits. But the fact that I didn't know the risk management that properly, that actually hit me a bit. So I needed to focus more on that. That's one thing that I took down. So when I went solo on this, like literally I started focusing more on risk management. Then I started telling myself that, you know what, at the end of the tunnel, there'll always be a light, so I can also make it out. And then from there, you know, I started slowly growing my account, you know. It was exciting, you know, because it was like guaranteed profits, you know. Like, you know, when you're expecting profits from the markets, it's not like you're biting your nails hoping that they'll come, but you're expecting it. I started being in such situations. And then at the end of the day, like, one thing that also helped too is that, like, while doing that, I told myself that, okay, no, with this small amount of capital, no matter how much money I make every month, I'm gonna also fund something. So let me just continue pushing whatever that I'm selling on the side, and then whatever profits that I make, I'm also gonna add, deposit something into it. It could be 1,000, it could be 500 rands, because obviously I'm not making that much money at the time. I'm still, I even left college at this time. So like even my target audience, my target market that I was selling the things that, it was actually at school. So now I haven't got, it's just like at home back in the hood. So it was a bit tough, but I just continued doing that, and like it helped me be able to just save money too, because I wasn't going out. I was like always indoors. I was always reading books, always watching videos, always just learning about the forex market. Then at the end of the day, like while doing that, it brings me back to actually the method that I actually spoke about in the previous video on how to actually deposit or fund your trading account. And if you haven't, please do make sure to just watch that video, how much to actually invest into my forex trading account. Yeah, so I started focusing on the second method, on which in that video I spoke about it. It's actually being able to just compoundly invest into your account. So with the $200, like it now I made, let's say, $30 profits for the month, and then with that $30 I have like what, $60 that I made from my side hustle. So I'll take that money out, invest it back into the forex market, and now my account keeps on growing. And that way I was able to just slowly, like each and every month, I'd make profits, I'd make $50 or maybe $40. At the same time, I'd fund my account with a few dollars too. And then like I think it was like a few months down the line, it got to a point whereby I didn't need to keep on funding my account anymore. It was like in a position whereby now I'm actually gonna sit back and enjoy the amount of money that is gonna actually make me. And with the profits that it actually made me, I was able to just withdraw, and then I started focusing more on side businesses that will be able to just help me in the longer run. Whether I trade forex or not, I should still be able to make a profit for the day. So I started focusing a bit more on that, and it helped me too. So while I was doing that, while I was focusing a bit more on those profits, like on the money that I make from the market, I'm building more passive income, I would say passive income. And I came along, like just by doing that, I learned a few things, and I learned that with the money that I'm making from passive income, I can invest it back into my trading account. So now the money can just keep on going like this, and my account can keep on getting bigger. I take big positions, I make big profits, and then it builds onto my businesses. At the same time, the money that the businesses make, the profits make, it goes back into the market. So it's like a cycle. I started focusing a bit more on that. Obviously, we started small, but as time went on, we started just it became like baby steps, and we were moving forward bit by bit, and now got to a point where I'm very confident within the markets. Like when I'm trading forex, like I'm very confident when I'm placing trades, whether it's a small account, big accounts. And one thing that I've noticed is that whether you have a big account or a small account, it's always like the same thing. Like, you know, whatever trades that you place, it's always, you're seeing the same things in the markets. Doesn't mean now that your account is big, you're gonna have to do something different. Obviously, you're gonna have to just place the lot size differently, but that's all. So I started focusing a bit on that, leaving emotions in like placing trades, and it helped me out a lot. It literally helped me out a lot. But at the end of the day, like we literally started off trading with like $22, and all the way, like we just built it. And like even for you, if you start trading with $100, literally you won't just fund $100 and then become a millionaire from just funding $100. That $100 is the start of actually what you're gonna be going to be experiencing, because you might grow it massively into big amounts, then you lose a few of it, and then you learn lessons, and then you do, and then on the way, like whatever that you'll be learning on the way is actually what you're gonna take with you. And when you get to a point where you're a bit more comfortable and confident with yourself, you'd be able to use that to your advantage, and you'd be able to make profits just like that, like, you know, daily, weekly, those are possible. Like I never thought that there would be days whereby I'll be closing profits and then being able to withdraw them, hitting my bank account, like on just normal days. And like experiencing that is actually amazing, and I want that for you too. So I hope actually I helped a lot of you guys with this video, with the message that I said on how to actually like how the real biography of how I actually get the capital to start off trading. And I hope that someone out there is getting a lot of value from this. Like you actually I'm gonna be implementing this into your life, and you'd be able to just help out someone out there too. But at the same time, please do make sure to hit the subscribe button if you like the words that I'm talking, and make sure to also hit the thumbs up if you actually liked this video, it helped you somehow. And please do also share so other people can be able to get let's say the knowledge, or maybe the experience that I've been through, so they can also know that even on their journey, it's okay for them to be going or experiencing what it is that they're experiencing now. But thank you so much. It's your boy, this is Mamutupi. If you haven't, please do make sure to check out my other videos. I've got tons of videos on my YouTube channel. You'll be able to just check them out and get a lot of information from them too. Thank you guys so much.